Evening, folks, this is Best in Slot with our ninth video of the day. That sounds insane when I say it out loud. Highlighting all the new features of the Return to Jurassic Park DLC. In this video, we're going to take a look at the Triceratops, remodeled, brand new skins, and of course, as with the Rex and with the Raptor, we're going to compare it to its original model to see exactly where those improvements have occurred. That said, I won't waste any more time. There are 6 new skins to take a look at, including the default 1993 version. We're going to compare it a little bit with its movie counterparts, but Triceratops did not really have an appearance in 1997. It had a very brief appearance in 1997 and didn't appear at all, as far as I recall, in 2001. So its movie skins are really limited to the OG film. Let's take a look at the start with our 1993 pattern. And there she is, looking beautiful. I think maybe she needs some food, actually. I'm pretty sure she needs some food. Looking absolutely majestic, as Triceratops, as one of my favourite dinosaurs, always does. But she is a vast improvement. It's hard to put into words exactly why. This is why we do the comparisons. Because I can look at that Triceratops and say to myself, that's a good-looking Triceratops. And I can look at the Jurassic World Triceratops and think, that is a bad-looking Triceratops. But I can't quite put into words why. For one, again, not to harp on the normal maps, but the normal maps are substantially better in this new version of the Triceratops. You can see from the scales, from the work on the body in general, it just looks a lot better. It's a lot less blurry, there's a lot more detail, the skin is much more interesting to look at. The default pattern is much more interesting. This is, of course, the pattern from Jurassic Park. It's not perfect. I've talked about this a lot, so I'm not going to go on about this for too long, but basically the Triceratops in Jurassic Park was actually blue. The default animatronic, the default model, was blue in coloration. Then they brought it into the film and had it lie down in the dirt and the dust, and it kind of became this orangey brown color that people associate with the Triceratops. This, to me, looks kind of halfway between the two. It's got this brown coloring on the sides, but it's also got some hints of blue there in the face, in the frill, and stuff like that. I'd say this is about half and half between the film version we saw and what the actual model looked like. I'm pretty happy with that. I think it's a pretty good compromise. I really love the mottling around the face, although it kind of looks a little diseased, but that's okay. And generally speaking, it is a beautiful looking Triceratops. We're going to take a look at all the skins and then we'll do ourselves a cheeky little comparison. So, moving on to our next one then, it is 1993 pattern A. All the skins we're going to see now are alternate versions of this 1993 pattern. Isn't she beautiful? Again, the camera's funky today. Exact same pattern, you can see that mottling on the face and the same textures going on, but she looks ancient. She looks like this buried stone warrior kind of thing that's been covered and overgrown with moss over time. The default patterning is just so much more interesting than the, let's be honest, exceptionally boring Jurassic World variant of the Triceratops. Even though the Triceratops did get some pretty okay alternate skins, the basic patterning is so incredibly dull that it really had nowhere to go. This one, however, is interesting. There's different variations in texture, in colour, in pattern across the whole body. It really does look like it's covered in moss. It's very, very cool. Big fan of you, buddy. Big fan. How do you feel? Do you feel good? Do you feel proud? Looks straight at the camera. A bit of a gym moment there. Right, moving on then. So we're going for A. What's next? That's right, it's B. Crazy. Let's go. Ladies and gentlemen. So this is seemingly our alpine equivalent, really. One of the cool things about this new skin system, the way they've applied it, is that you can take this default texture and then you can just chuck all these different colours on, and it doesn't have to fit the prescribed notions we already have via the rainforest, via the taker, via all the different skin systems we have in the game. They can do whatever the hell they want because it's just labelled A, B, C, D. But given the skins in the game already cover a whole range of colours, it's not that surprising we're going to get some that would match what we already have. And that includes this. I think if you pop this out as an Alpine Triceratops, you wouldn't be surprised at all. It looks like an Alpine Triceratops. And as somebody who roundly dislikes Alpine skins, I really don't have much to say about this one. It is boring, I'm afraid. Again, it's better than the default one, that modelling on the face. Again, the way the beak and the frontal horn in particular stick out amongst the skin is actually really cool. I think that's probably one of the bigger changes in the Triceratops. Also, same with the Stegosaurus. But yeah, we're going to move on to bigger and hopefully better things. This is 1993 Pattern C. I'm ever so slightly curious if the skins have been based around existing patterns anyway, because this right here, this is a dead ringer for a, what would you call it? This would be a jungle pattern. Jungle in this game is basically a crimson red sort of colour, and that again pretty much perfectly matches what we've got right here. It does look really nice though. I love seeing Triceratops with this big burst of colour that really stands out. It looks bloodied, especially around the neck, the lower haunches of the head, a little bit down here at the body. It looks like it's got blood on its lower chest. It's really interesting. That mottling pattern, I'm going to say the word mottling far too much, even if not appropriate, this sort of veined look it has near the eyes in that light creamy texture really pops against the red as well, which I like a lot. Triceratops is my personal favourite dinosaur, and I never really connected with the Jurassic World Evolution variant. That is no longer a problem. It's a big, chunky unit, and I love it. With some great looking skins, I will say. Green is maybe at the top for me, followed by the default, followed by the red, followed by the alpine. That's my four so far. Let's see where pattern D can fall in that list. And where pattern D falls is right at the top. That for me is an awesome skin. That is a very, very, very cool skin. I'm a huge fan of that. Those who see my channel will know that I kind of like dinosaurs with a pop of colour, dinosaurs that look a little bit of inventive to their skin patterning, and this does that in spades. I am starting to notice a difference in the patterning. I don't know if I'm crazy. So these ones here, they've got this kind of, it almost looks tribal in a way, this patterning alongs the frill. Now this one here doesn't really have it. Well, it does, but it's very much faded out. That one, same kind of deal. You can see it just a little bit in the whiter textures. I did spot it before. I think it is present on all of them because at the end of the day, they're meant to have the same pattern. But the colouring, you see that, look at that frill, and then compare it to this frill over here. Now, whether that's a different pattern or simply a use of different colours is, you know, a whole other kettle of fish, but it does make it seem demonstrably different. That is awesome. It looks painted. It looks rusty. There's browns in there. There's creams. There's purples. It's unique. It stands out. It looks like an alpha off a pack. You know, that is possibly one of my favourite skins in the entire game. I love that. For an early champion, but can't, no, pattern D, I should say. I love the D. Can pattern E top the list? Let's find out. Pattern E is pretty nice. It's okay. I like the colour scheme. I like, again, the vividity, which I'm going to pretend is a word. It might be a word. Vividity. It should be how vivid something is. Vividity. I don't know. Off the, again, the frill has a noticeable pattern to it. The colours are lighter and they contrast quite well with each other. I will say my problem with E is that it looks like a lesser version of D. They are quite similar in their color choices. You know, it's like a lighter version of it. But I think because of that one's lighter in general, there's less contrast. It makes it look a little bit less interesting, and therefore D kind of stands out as just being insane. I mean, you see them from above, and D really, I'm obsessed with it. It really, really does stand out really well. But this is a really good set of skins in general. All Triceratops fans out there should be thrilled. We've got a colourful group over here. We've got a slightly more chill group. Whatever you like in your trike, that rhymes, must be true, you have an answer for right here. Now, to finish things off then, we're going to hop back over into Photoshop, as we have been doing all day. We're going to compare the default 1993 trike with the Jurassic World trike, and see if we can spot exactly what they've done to make my big boy just that little bit better. So as promised then, to close things out, let's do a little bit of a comparison with the OG Triceratops and the brand new one, because just like with the other dinosaurs, some of these changes are really subtle, but they come together to make an overall much more appealing creature. Now, if we focus on the body itself, there doesn't appear to have been widespread changes. There are, of course, like I mentioned, much better normal maps. You see the scales all over the body, not present there at all. This one looks like a big bag of leather. This one looks like a dinosaur. That is really the key difference. It also has some more interesting patterning. We've got these thick, circular, well, sort of oblong circle, otherwise known as an oval, I guess, scales that kind of descend along the back. They're different colours on some of the skins. It's really interesting. You see some thicker scales there on the legs. Again, nothing here on our Jurassic World trike, although it does have a slightly bendy spine, which this one doesn't have. The tail does appear to have thickened up a little bit, but I'm not sure on that. Now, let's focus on the head. So, what are the differences? I think the beak has been made a little bit bigger. It's definitely been increased in contrast compared to the rest of the skin. The little bit that juts out here below the eye is sharper on our new trike, and I think this may be the bigger change. But as far as I can tell, the frill is wider, but also angled further back than this one. Is very, very vertical. This one points more in this direction than it does. I think it gives it an overall better shape. We see the same with the horns. The front one, not so much, but these two right here, on this trike, it's very clearly pointing straight forwards. This one is kind of pointing up into the sky and kind of splaying out in different directions, which again, I think makes it look better, basically. I don't really know how else to put that. I just think it's an improvement. It's little things that all come together. I mean, if you looked at these two images individually, I do think most people would instantly say that the top Triceratops is much better looking. And it's not just because of the skin. You know, of course, the skin is better. Those new scales are a humongous improvement. They really make all the difference in the world to the dinosaur. But just generally speaking, I think the model, though subtle, is noticeably better. Cool stuff. It's also less weirdly wrinkly down here, which I'm usually against, but in this case I'll take it. Like, there's less of these folds absolutely everywhere. It looks more like it's a built tank rather than a saggy bag of leather, basically. Look, I don't like the Jurassic World Triceratops. I never pretended otherwise. I also think that just like with the Rex, and indeed the Raptor, this is a fairly common trait amongst these new dinosaurs. The snout has been extended quite a bit with this new version above as well. I know I'm not quite matching that, but I think the snout is longer on this top version than it is on this one, but I'm not really sure. Everything always just feels a little bit more angled, a little bit more dangerous. The beak definitely points out further as well, as you can see right there. That's quite close to the mouth. Right then. Triceratops, done. Let me know what you think in the comments down below. Which of these five is your new favourite skin of the bunch? Triceratops, again, is one of those dinosaurs that's going to go vastly up in my estimations just because of the quality of the skin and the quality of the new model. That's a really good look there, just there as we finish off the scales that I was on about. They are not present at all on the old skin, and there they are, just making the body just more interesting to look at. And who doesn't love an interesting body? Thank you for joining me. If you enjoyed this video, and indeed the many thousands of videos I've produced today, please do consider hitting that like button. Don't know why I have to say it like a weirdo. And subscribe if you want to be kept up to date with the several more videos I have planned for today. Until then, thank you so much for joining me. Cheers, my love, as always. Bye-bye. Hey folks, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video and you want to help support me a little bit more, you can do so at patreon.com/bestinslot. There's a link in the description down below. Every little really does help in times like these, but it's not at all expected, and by just watching the video, you've already helped me out massively, and it makes you a pretty cool person, so well done you. Thanks for joining me either way, I'll see you next time.